Hi, I'm Walter, an exhibit developer at the Ontario Science Centre. We're in the middle of putting together a brand new exhibition all about sport. During the last 2 weeks of February, while the Winter Olympics are on, we're going to be testing two experiences, and it'll be your chance to come and be an exhibit developer with us and prototype human curling. We're here at the Cricket Club with Sandy Graham, who's an expert in curling, who's going to give us a few pointers.
Excellent. Slippery pointers.
Slippery pointers. So what can you tell us about the sport?
It's just such a fantastic sport. It's a game of all ages. To learn it, we could give you a little curling 101 lesson and you could throw a rock in 15 to 20 minutes. To master it, I'll let you know. I'll let you know when I get there. Well, I guess in its simplest form, the point of the game is to score one more point than your opposition.
Okay.
And the way you score a point is trying to get closer to the button, which is kind of similar to the bullseye on a dartboard. And in an end of curling, which is like an inning in baseball, after both teams have thrown all their rocks, they take a look and see who's the closest to the button, and that team will score a point.
Okay. And what's involved? What are the elements of the sport?
There's a lot involved, you know. It's often described because there's a lot of strategy involved, a bit like chess on ice. You also have to take into consideration the delivery of the rock, where you're extended into a lunge position where it's testing your balance, your leg endurance and strength, trying to let go of the rock cleanly so you don't manipulate it at all on its course. And we call this game curling because your rocks will not go straight down a sheet of ice because of the pebble on it. So if you just throw a rock with the handle pointing straight, the ice is going to dictate which way that rock is going to curl. But as we deliver the stone, we can dictate how that rock is going to curl by applying a certain turn. If we apply an intern, the rock's going to curl in a certain direction.
And so an intern for a right-handed curler, would that be a clockwise turn?
Correct.
Okay. And so if you throw a rock with a clockwise turn, what's it going to do? How is it going to curl?
Well, if you're throwing it with a clockwise turn, the rock is going to take that turn and curl either to the right or the left, depending on which side of the sheet you're throwing it on. It's interesting to me that if we were to take one of our curling rocks next door to our skating rink, and I was to throw it as hard as I could, it would maybe go 15 feet because it's on flat ice. We take it onto curling ice, and that pebble that we talk about is sort of like a ball bearing, where I could throw that rock with the same amount of force and it'd go through the back wall.
Wow.
Yeah.
There's even science in the ice we're standing on.
Exactly. There's science everywhere.
As I understand it, when we look at the physics, whether you're on ice or on a counter, it changes everything. And that a clockwise turn across a table is going to curl in the opposite direction than a stone on ice.
Really?
That's an experiment we need to try.
See, we learn something every day.
Yeah. So if I give it a clockwise turn, so we're on the ice, clockwise turn with the stone, you're telling me that...
To turn it clockwise.
To turn it clockwise. And in curling, that'll mean that the stone will turn, from my perspective, to the right.
Correct.
Okay. So here we are off the ice on a table. We have our glass, so I'm going to turn it clockwise.
Okay. Wow.
And it curled.
Finishes the other way.
Yeah, it curled left.
Interesting. And now what's the science behind it?
Well, the science, this actually...
Wow.
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
Curlers go, that's insane.
Yeah.
And physicists say that's exactly what's supposed to happen. In motion, sliding across the surface, frictional forces act against the direction of motion. So you have a push back from the surface. So it's just sliding in a straight line, this friction pushing back, and that's where it comes to a stop. The friction slows it down and eventually you're no longer moving forward. So now with a clockwise turn, the direction of motion at the front of the stone is to the right, and at the back of the stone is to the left, in addition to that slide. So when we put that all together, we have a forward push that's causing extra pressure on the front, then not on the back. We have frictional force opposing the motion that is now greater because of that downward push towards the left on the front of the stone, then the frictional force opposing the turn on the back of the stone. So the resultant friction forces the stone leftward, or at least the glass on the table.
Well, there you have it. Clockwise rotating curling stone curls to the right. Clockwise rotating glass curls to the left. Which way will our human curling stones curl? Well, you'll have to come to the Science Center to find out.